now what?
An opening comment?
My reaction to today?
Yeah, your reaction to the government.
Well, I found it, the one thing, the glaring omission in that speech was not one mention of the reform that people have been talking about over the last few months, of needing to fundamentally change the way we do business. And whether it's pensions, Medicaid, there's been continuous talk about cuts, nothing finalized, a variety of things, and it was more or less, give me my tax increase, and if you do, then you're acting like an adult, and we can solve this. The real tough work is changing this mentality. So we're here, I think, in many ways, we're here with a huge mess because my opinion in watching this is the Democrat infighting or civil war, whatever you want to call it, has propelled us to this situation. I'm hopeful that he's going to have a series of bills by the end of the night that get him to almost $26 billion, if not a little over $26 billion, and that he can, at least for a time, and how long that remains maybe unknown at the moment, but he can govern and govern adequately for a reasonable period of time.
Who's not an adult?
What happens?
Who's not an adult?
Yeah, who's not an adult?
I have no idea, because of what he's suggesting.
Yeah.
You'd have to ask him the specifics, and I'm not about to get into speculating on who he's talking about.
Tom, is this going to end up in resulting in a state shutdown at some point in July? I mean, is that the course that we're on?
I hope not. I don't think that does anybody any good. I think people would be severely harmed. They would be hurt from people that work for the state, the people that rely on services for the state, people who want to be protected by the state police. So that doesn't do anybody any good, and I hope that's not where we end up.
Would the Republicans support an override if the governor vetoes the budget?
We're going to actually talk about that in caucus here in a few minutes.
Great.
So I don't want to speak for our caucus without asking them what they think about that.
Okay.
That would certainly be an option.
Well, what
we will
do you
consider
think about it?
I'm going to wait and talk to my caucus about it.
Well, what do you personally think
I'm going to wait
it,
and talk.
If that meant averting a shutdown,
no, because
you don't want to see.
I don't want to shut down. And I don't think anybody in our caucus wants to shut down. But I'm going to talk to my caucus. We have not had that discussion about whether or not where they'll be on an override. And if I give you my opinion, then people will take that as my caucus's opinion. And I will know more. We had a conversation here with our leadership a few minutes ago, well, an hour ago. I said, we don't need to rush into this. We need to think about the pros and cons of it overnight. We're speculating. We don't know what he's going to do. He says he's going to do it, but he's also said several occasions he's for the capital bill and he's not going to sign the capital bill. I'm not sure anybody knows what he's going to do
on
the budget.
He threatens you with it. He says you're not acting like adults. How does that move the ball forward, and why wouldn't the legislature just say, that's what you think of us? We've been in this game before.
Yeah, there is a distinct possibility that happens, but again, I'm not going to, at this point, speak for my caucus on where they are, but that is an override would clearly put us back in the position where we'll probably be at the end of the night.
Well, why would you and your members even consider overriding a veto of the budget that you voted against in the first place?
We are going to talk about that in the next probably hour.
But what would be the pros and cons of that? I mean,
well, the pros and cons.
It seems like he would be vetoing something you would want him to veto.
Well, many in our caucus voted for the $16.9 billion that accessed the federal money. And I think, we have been trying to be responsible in this. We have some strong opposition to some things, like the tax hike, but where we've been able to work with his office and where we've been able to be helpful and move the ball forward. For instance, the 16.9, why would we vote no when we could access, and that was a way to access federal money and appropriate money for K-12 and higher ed. It seemed to be the responsible thing to do, so that's why we did it. We thought the pension bond, the five-year pension bond deal, why in a normal world, in a normal scenario, you might not embrace that, but to avoid a catastrophic situation, we thought that was the appropriate thing to do. So you're going to have a potential scenario where, assuming he vetoes everything, some of it we've supported, some of it we haven't. And then, of course, it begs the question, can you manage with $26 billion? And that would, you would have that. That was part of the equation. So I think we got to talk it through, and I don't have an answer right now, and I'm not gonna apologize for that.
If he did sign it and he could manage it for however long, what would happen during that interim period to change the equation? What do you gain by delaying things?
Well, if he signed it, we wouldn't be delaying anything. We would have,
I'm sorry, I was under the assumption that you meant sign it, govern for a while budget negotiations continue on a more permanent solution.
Well, I think forgetting the budget itself, what our whole point from day one has been reform. And so we will continue. There's a pension task force, a Medicaid task force, an economic recovery commission, a sunshine commission. Those things are going to take some time. And I think that none of that is new. So we will continue to participate that in an active way and an aggressive way and look for solutions in a timely manner.
One more question.
What the governor said, he didn't think that a budget extension was going to happen. He think it was possible.
What do you mean?
A 30-day budget, extending the current budget for another month. Do you see any chance yourself of just extending this budget by another month?
I think the problem, Rich, is what do you use for a figure? And one of our concerns is the governor would like a 30-day budget if this doesn't work. He wants it at that 30. You know, here's one of the other problems in all this exercise. You've seen numbers range from 28 to 29 to
right.
31 to 32. He wants the higher number, which contemplates a tax increase.
So he wants his introduced level at his tax increase level for 30 days,
yes.
Even though there's no revenue for the
yes.
state.
And then we find that problematic.
So he wanted the 30 days.
In an ideal world, he wanted a tax increase.
Right.
And there was some discussion, I don't want to put words in his mouth, about a 30-day budget in that scenario that I just laid out, the higher number. We said we didn't see support at our caucus for a 30-day budget that contemplates a tax increase, because then what happens?
Is that a half-baked budget?
It's a budget that if there's no tax increase, sets up the need to cut later, and it's hard to.
Is that a half-baked budget?
You'd have to ask him if he thinks it's a half-baked budget. I think I've heard that term somewhere.
About twice.
Is it an adult budget?
All right, thanks, guys.
Not going to play these sophomore games that John Patterson's trying to get me to do.